friends, Ellen here, and welcome back to my channel. You very well might be somebody who found me because of one of my more popular Notion videos. Maybe it was my Notion recurring tasks video. And today I'm gonna be doing an update to that video because a couple weeks ago while I was kind of busy and flying around and doing all my like speaking stuff, Notion released an update to their recurring templates feature that is a game changer when it comes to recurring tasks. If you saw that previous video, you might be one of the many people that commented and you were like, this isn't that simple. But at the time, it was actually a very simple workaround for doing Notion recurring tasks. You know, relatively speaking to a lot of the other workarounds I'd seen, it was a pretty damn simple workaround. Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you the update that they made that makes this even more simple, like actually easy AF to do recurring tasks in Notion, as well as if you have any of my templates, how to modify and update those templates so that you can do recurring tasks using this feature. It's vastly more streamlined, it's vastly more simplified, and I cannot wait to dive into it with you. So let's do it.
Oh my gosh, you guys, I am literally so excited to show you this. So I have been using recurring templates in my Notion systems for a really, really long time. I had to create like a crazy workaround for how to do recurring tasks previously. Let me actually pull up my template, my free template, so that I can show you how I used to do recurring tasks. So I've got my free Notion planner template right here. You can go ahead and get the link down in the description. And by the time you guys get the link, it will be updated to include the new recurring tasks feature. But this is what I used to do previously. I had my tasks database. And what I had to do for a recurring task is I had to use this crazy show in calendar property, which basically how this property works. Here, let me move my face out of the way. Whoops, pop back up, my friend. Basically how this property works is I have a checkbox where I would check it to indicate that it's a recurring task. And if it is a recurring task, this tells it to use the due date. If it is not a recurring task, this formula tells it to use the due date for its date. And if it is a recurring task, it tells it to use the created time for its due date. So I had to do all of these extra properties to get the recurring template to work. But now, this is the beautiful thing. So now to set up recurring templates inside of Notion, all I have to do is I have to set the due date for today. Let me show you what I mean. So previously, this is how I used to have to do it. So we'll go in here and let's say, I don't know, maybe your recurring task is that you need to do laundry every week. So I used to have to check this recurring box. So then the date that it was created would become the show in calendar date. This was the date that I used to sort all of my tasks. So let's go ahead and now that I've created that template, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply it so you can kind of see here. So now this would become my quote unquote due date for my task was this date right here. Now we no longer have to do that. Now what we can go ahead and do, instead of doing this, we can delete this recurring template property. And if you, I'll say this right now before I forget, if you do use my templates, this is how you can fix it for all of my templates so that you don't have to have all of these extra properties anymore. So the first thing that you can go ahead and do is click on this recurring checkbox guy, delete it. We don't need it anymore. You can also go in and you can click the show and calendar guy and delete that too because we don't need that property anymore. Like look how much it's already cleaning up our properties. Last but not least, you can also go in and delete the created time property. Now, if you use that property for something else, you might wanna keep it around. But we don't necessarily need it to make the recurring templates function anymore. So now all we have to do once we've deleted these three properties is under due date, click in here and click today. You see how when you do that, it says time, date when duplicated. And then it also says time when duplicated. Now, I don't necessarily care about specific times on my task because I don't necessarily do time blocking. I just care about the date. So if you just want the date for when it is duplicated to be used, you're gonna click this one. If you want the date and time when it's duplicated to be used, you wanna use the now function. So click whichever one you want. And then what we're gonna do, we have one more step to really make sure this works. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna click up next to that task in here, this template, click the three dot menu next to this template. And this is the part that's the same for what we used to do in the past. Let me go ahead and actually adjust my video slightly. So what we're gonna go ahead and do, why aren't you scrolling, you stupid thing? So once again, click those three dots, click And then what you want to do is you want to go up here to where it says repeat. So now right now, this is a template that I'm not using because this is one that's just an example template inside of my free Notion planner. But for any task that you want to create a recurring task, you just need to go in here and you need to tell Notion how often you want them to repeat this task. If it's a daily recurrence, tell it daily. So you can go in and you can say every 2 days, every 5 days, however often you want this to recur on a daily basis, this is what you will indicate here. And you can also tell it when you want it to start and when you want it to create that event. The other thing you can do is do repeat weekly. And this is really cool because say you want something to occur every Monday and Thursday, not necessarily every 4 days, but every Monday and Thursday, you can go in here and you can select Monday and Thursday. You could also say, I want it to occur every Monday, but I want it to be every 2 weeks or every 3 weeks, so on and so forth. And you can also, again, set the time. I personally just leave all of my times to be created at 12 a.m. so that when I wake up in the morning, they're just there. You can also do monthly. So if you want something to recur every 2 months, every 3 months, every 6 months, however frequently you want it to occur, you can set that as well. And then last but not least, every year. And again, you can indicate how frequently over the course of the years you want it to happen. So whatever frequency you want, that's what you're going to set under the repeat. And then once you've done that, let me click outside of this, you'll see this little blue arrow. And that little blue arrow tells you that you have successfully set up your recurring task. So again, just to reiterate, we need to set the due date as at today if you just want the date, and at now if you want the date and time. And then you want to go through and you want to create your templates. So let me give you an example of another template. Maybe we also want to remind ourselves to like check the mail, because I know I personally forget to check the mail. So create your template. Maybe you want to add like a little icon to it or something like that. And then you want to set the due date as at today or at now. Again, depends on your preference, depends on what you want. And then you want to go in here and you want to say how frequently you want this to happen. So I might say every week on Saturday or something like that. And now this is set up to recur every week. So this is how easy it is now to create recurring templates in Notion. I'm going to clear these. So if you do go in and snag this template, which again, you can find it in the description below, you'll be very, very easily able to create your own recurring templates using this database right here. To give you some ideas of the different templates that I use and the different recurring tasks that I have a lot of them. I'm going to mentally prepare you for that. But some of the ones that I have are things like planning my next membership training. When I do quarterly launches, I have a template for that. Monthly financial tasks, quarterly health tasks. I have certain things I'm supposed to do for my day job. I have a reminder to turn off my out of office because sometimes I forget to turn it off. I have to renew my car tabs. I have to clean my Keurig and descale it and all of that. I have to check my mail. I have to renew certification. So I have like so many. I have cleaning tasks down here. I actually just recently reintegrated my cleaning tasks, which I had put in a separate database, but I didn't like it because I kept forgetting about them. I reintegrated them into my task. And you can see really all I had to do to go back through and update this is just like I showed for you guys. I deleted all my extra properties. I deleted my recurring property. I deleted my show and calendar property. And you know what? I haven't done it yet, but I think I'm going to because I don't really need it in here. I'm going to delete my creation date property. And then all I have set up here, let me go ahead and shrink down all my properties again, is my due date being today. And then this guy is set to repeat. I don't remember which one I just looked at, but this guy is set to repeat every 2 weeks on Saturday. This guy is set. Oops, did I just add a, I might have accidentally added a task down here. I don't know. Some of these other ones are set to repeat every 3 months. So you can kind of see the pattern that I have in here. And I have all sorts of different tasks that I use. So this is the super, super easy way you can set up recurring tasks in Notion. Once again, just use this recurring tasks, this recurring templates guy over here. I'm getting there by just clicking the down button next to the new create your template. And then once you've created your template, one, go into your due date and click at today. And then anytime that new template gets created, the due date for the current day, the day it is duplicated, will be assigned to the task. So pumped that Notion finally released this feature. It is a game changer and it's really more and more making Notion like the productivity app for so many of us.
That is it. That is the end of this update. I hope you are as excited about this Notion update as I am. Seriously, it's going to streamline recurring tasks so much. It actually, as I've started implementing it for myself, it constantly like, I'm like, oh yeah, this is so much simpler now. Like I don't have to do all of these crazy workarounds anymore. And I am super excited about it. So I hope you are as well. I hope it's going to streamline and simplify things in your Notion system. If you've got any questions about this that I didn't touch on in the video, do not forget to drop them below. And with that, thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching. And I will see you next time. Bye.